Matthew chapter 15 verse 2. Matthew chapter 15 verse 2. Why do the disciples transgress the tradition of the elders? For they wash not their hands when they eat bread. Verse 3. But he answered and said unto them, why do he also transgress the commandment of the Most High power by your tradition? So this is one of the many dialogues that Christ and his disciples had with the scribes and Pharisees. This one in per se is about how they upheld their traditions above the commandment of God. They found issue with Christ and his disciples because they neglect the traditions of the elder. And likewise, Christ and his disciples found issue with the scribes and Pharisees transgressing the commandments of the Heavenly Father. As you see in this society, you see us brothers right here, many Christians found issue with us that we no longer keep the tradition which we were raised upon. We no longer follow Sunday. We no longer follow Easter, Thanksgiving. We no longer follow the traditions of man, but rather we follow the laws and statutes that's written in the commandment. We follow the high holy day that was given unto us by our fathers. Read verse 4. Verse 4. For a higher commandment saying, honor thy father and thy mother. So Christ is bringing forth this truth to the Pharisees out there. He's letting them know what thus saith the Most High. Read again. Verse 4. For the higher commanded saying, honor thy father and thy mother. He said, for Christ said, honor thy father and thy mother. For this is what was spoken of the Heavenly Father. Jump down to verse 7. Verse 7. He hypocrite will Isaiah prophesied to you saying. So now Christ done finished bringing forth the information out of the law. Now he's going to the prophet. Because the prophet dealt with the same issue that Christ dealt with. A hypocrite, hypocrisy. People dealing with their own tradition, man-made tradition, following the precepts of man. Read. Verse 8. This people draw nigh unto me with their mouth, but their heart is far. Slakia. This people draw nigh unto me with their mouth and honor me with their lips, but their heart is far from me. So Christ is quoting from the prophet Elias that these people is man pleasers. They want to hear things that's pleasing, but they're not willing to receive this truth. Get me Ezekiel chapter 33 verse 31. They'd rather fall into traditions of the elders, the precepts of man, rather than follow the commandments of the living God. We gotta shun away from this. We gotta now start keeping the commandments that's written in scripture. Keep the mic back. Ezekiel 33 and 21. And they came unto thee as the people cometh, and they you have many brothers and sisters that come to us and listen to what we have to say. And we take heed or we just listen, but they're not willing to do it. They're not willing to obey what thus saith the Most High.
Read.
For with their mouth they show much love, but their heart is gone after their covetousness.
So they're following after their own heart, the lust of the world, the lust of the eyes, and the pride of life. It is not of the Father, but is of this world. The traditions of man, that's your Easter, your Thanksgiving, your New Year's. There's nowhere it can be found in Scripture. But rather, we have high holy days that's written in Leviticus chapter 23. The Passover, the Feast of Dedication, Purim. Continue up.
Ezekiel 33 and 32. And lo, there are unto them as a very lovely song that had a pleasant voice and can play well on the instrument that they hear why thy word, but they do them not.
So the Most High is saying that what we're bringing forth is very pleasant, but yet the children of Israel would not take heed to it. They would not take heed to this information that we bring it forth. Read.
Verse 33. Then this came to Shalakia, and then this came to pass. Lo, it will come that shall they know that a prophet has been among them.
So when destruction hit, then you're going to know a prophet was among you. When we're telling you to repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand, turn from your wickedness, then you will know that a prophet was among you. Let me 2 Thessalonians chapter 2. We must repent from our evil doings. Stop following the traditions of man that we learn as young babes. The Christian church, all their tradition is not written in Scripture. You can't find Sunday worship. You can't find Easter. You can't find Thanksgiving. You can't find New Year's. It's nowhere to be found in Scripture.
Amen.
Read
2 Thessalonians 2 and 1.
Verse 10.
Verse 10, Salakia. And will all deceivableness of unrighteousness in them that perish because they receive not the love of the truth that they might be saved.
So when we hear, bring it forth the truth and bring it forth the understanding of what we are to do and what we are to follow, you will not take heed to it. Destruction is on its way because of that. While the man of the Most High was telling you to repent and take heed, you follow not. You take no heed. Read.
Verse 11. For this curse, Ahiah shall send them a strong delusion that they should believe a lie.
So rather believing is truth, the Most High is going to send a strong delusion that you may believe a lie.
Amen.
You'll rather believe a lie rather than the truth. Get me Romans chapter 1 verse 28. The precept for that. Because you denounce these laws, these commandments, you're going to rather believe a lie. Read.
Romans chapter 1 verse 28. And even as they did not like to retain the Most High power in their knowledge,
because you rejected the Most High's law, statutes, and commandment, we,
Ahiah, gave them over unto reprobate mind.
Because you reject the law, statutes, and commandment that was written in Scriptures, the high holy days that we ought to follow, you would rather now be given it to a reprobate mind. You would rather now believe in a lie. Get me Ezekiel chapter 7, verse 12. We got to turn from that. You have the man of the Most High in the highways and byways proclaiming forth the truth, letting you know it's time to repent. Turn from the traditions of man, the Babylonian systems. Easter, that's Babylonian. None of our forefathers were celebrating Easter. None of our forefathers were celebrating Halloween or Thanksgiving, but they brought us here in this land. It's time to wake up. Read. Zechariah chapter 7, verse 12. We have to stop following the tradition, these man-made traditions, these man-made precepts, and begin to follow the laws of the living God. Begin to keep the Sabbath day holy, for it is written, these commandments bring forth life. Why have you chosen death rather than life? That's the same question Christ came forth and asked. That's the same question the disciples and the prophets. And now we're asking the same question. Why have you chose death rather than life? Read.
Zechariah chapter 7, verse 12. Yea, they made their heart as an adamant stone, lest they should hear the law and the word which the higher of hosts have said. In this, in his
while the Most High would raise up prophets in the morning to tell Israel to repent, stop following the traditions of the heathen. But no, they're so indulged, they want to be joined in. Every other day you have our people marching, trying to fit in to the society. This society don't care about you. Read.
The men left 12 by the former prophet, therefore came the great wrath from the Most High power of
Saul. So when the Most High sent forth his prophets in the morning to tell the nation to repent, stop following the traditions of their elders, stop following Easter, stop worshiping him on the Sunday, because he took not counsel of the prophet. Read.
Verse 13. Therefore it came to pass that as he cried, and they would not hear. So they cried, and would not hear, said the Most High power.
So we're crying out to you this night, telling you to repent, telling you stop following this man-made tradition that Christ had to tell the scribes and Pharisees. Stop following their man-made tradition, which they upheld above the commandments of God. You shall not add or take away from the words of the living God. That's written in Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 2.
Read. Verse 14. But I scattered them with a whirlwind among all nations, when they knew not that the land was desolate.
Because of our rebelliousness, because of our stiff-neckedness, the Most High has scattered us abroad. We are in places in Haiti, Jamaica, the West Indies, North America, South America. We're still in the West and the East, all scattered in the four corners of the earth because of our disobedience. We have to put down these man-made traditions and follow the commandments that's written. Follow these scriptures. When Christ brought forth this information, he told the scribes and Pharisees, for this is what was commanded of him by the Heavenly Father. Amen.